ಧರ್ಮಾರ್ಥ ಸುಖ ಸಾಧನಂ ಕಾಲವೇದೋಪದೇಶೇಷು ವಿಧೇಯೇ ಪರಮಾದರಃ ಆಯುಕ್ತಮಯಮಾನೇನ ಧರ್ಮಾರ್ಥ ಸುಖ ಸಾಧನಂ ಕಾಲವೇದೋಪದೇಶೇಷು ವಿಧೇಯೇ ಪರಮಾದರಃ.
Dear viewers, Ayurveda, the knowledge of life and longevity, is perhaps the oldest existing body of knowledge on the healing process. It is not merely a medical system, it is a way of life. This knowledge system deals with not only the problems of the body and mind, but also that of the human spirit and consciousness. In these days of changing paradigms, when Western science is looking to Eastern logic and spirituality to find solutions to physical, mental, spiritual and social problems, it is important for us to rediscover this holistic thought process in the interest of humanity at large. It is our humble attempt through this series to bring Ayurveda and its allied knowledge systems into your homes and hearts. We hope we have your blessings in this purposeful journey of ours. These days wants to be slim. Everyone wants to keep good health. Does being slim necessarily mean being healthy? Who actually is a healthy person? According to World Health Organization's definition of health, health is a complete physical, mental and social well-being and not merely the absence of disease or infirmity. These men and women you just saw, would you say were healthy or unhealthy? I know it's a tricky question indeed. Even the WHO may find it difficult to answer that. In India, we have always had our own time-tested standards by which our people measured and rated their health and ill health and led meaningful lives. Of course, at the root of all that indigenous wisdom lay the teachings of Ayurveda. Nagarjuna, the great Ayurveda master, has given us 15 indicators to measure health in a human being. These pointers of good health are as relevant today as they were to our great grandfathers.
क्षणं पञ्चदश प्रकारम् आहारकांशास्वदनं विपाकः तत्लक्षणं पञ्चदश प्रकारम् आहारकांशास्वदनं विपाकः पुरेशमूत्रानिलसृष्टतार्च तदेन्द्रियार्थक्रगणे च शक्ति पुरेशमूत्रानिलसृष्टतार्च तदेन्द्रियार्थग्रगणे च शक्ति मनःसुखत्वं बलवर्णलाभ स्वप्नसुखेन प्रतिबोधनं च मनःसुखत्वं बलवर्णलाभ स्वप्नसुखेन प्रतिबोधनं च उपायत साधनमस्य विद्यात् स्नेहादि यत् कर्म मया प्रदिष्टम् उपायत साधनमस्य विद्यात् स्नेहादि यत् कर्म मया प्रदिष्टम् विद्याधिहारोग्यफलं नराणां धर्मार्थकाम प्रतिमोक्षसिद्ध विद्याधिहारोग्यफलं नराणां धर्मार्थकाम प्रतिमोक्षसिद्ध धर्मार्थकाम प्रतिमोक्षसिद्ध
तदलक्षणं पञ्चदशप्रग आहारकांश यू शुड हैव डिजायर फॉर taking your food on time, if it is your breakfast time, lunch time or dinner time, whatever time you have fixed or your community or your culture says, that time you are naturally, your body should ask for food. That is the right appetite, ahara kamsha. Even if you eat proper food and proper time, if the digestion is not there, sodhanam vipaga, that also is an aberration. Sodhanam vipaga, if your digestion is properly without any gas formation, without any bulging, without any all. That's another indication of health. Because GIT, gastrointestinal tract, is one of the most important functional part of the body which actually makes difference in health and disease. Because that is the originator of all diseases. Then Purisha Mutra Anila Sushtadasha. There are three ways of eliminating body's waste material. One is Purisham, stool, or the bowel movement. That should be on time. You know that people get, especially in our culture, people get early morning evacuation without any difficulty, without waiting for any of these tips to get a most, it should not be there. And mutram also, proper urination on time. 5 to 6 is ordinary time for urination. And anila sushtadacha, and also the gases that is always forms in the system, should be eliminated without any sound, without any smell, without even knowledge of the person, should be going continuously. That is another indication of health. Tadendriyartha Grihanech Chakti. We have got five sense organs, eye, nose, tongue, ear and skin. These are the five organs through which we understand external world. Any of this or all of this along with your mind. So if these five sense organs are able to get things observed, that is another indication. Manasugattvam, that is more important. You have all these things. If your state of mind is not in a peaceful condition, it's not health. Manasugattam should be there. That can be further defined for all yams together. But I am just giving you a definition. There should be mental peace. You should be in a tranquility of mind. Bala Varna Labha. This is the one aspect I think only Ayurveda has well explained. Balam and Varnam. Even if you are eating properly, digestion is there, all these things. If you don't have the strength, strength are there of three kinds. Natural strength. By birth, by your genetical characters, you are supposed to be a strong of certain grade, if you have got that. Certain ethnic communities like the Negro, like the African people or the like, the Indian ethnic community, they have got a kind of strength which is natural to them. That strength is there, and also according to the bias, according to the age, if you are a youthful person, you should have that particular kind of strength, or according to a special type of food you are taking. So all this kind of strength, if it is available in your system, if it is expressed in your system, that is another indication of health. Varna labha, varnam is very important, the texture. You can see people of who are not very healthy, it is shown on your face. Even we say in our this thing that your face says that. If you take improper food also, we can see that different discoloration, which may not be very easily observed by people, but people of medical eye can understand that different texture of the skin that develops out of the imbalance that is being developed in the system. Balavarna labha. Swapana sukhena pradibodhanam cha. These are the two important, many of us do not. Swapana sukhena, that means we say that as soon as you see your bed, you should be able to sleep. Or people should sleep and go to the bed if you are properly healthy. There is no need for any other support system to health. Swapana sukhena, that means you should have a proper sleep without disturbances, not getting up in between and all those things. And pradibodhanam cha, that is one of the most important indicator of health. See, Brahme Muhurte Uttishtha, that is the right time of Brahme Muhurtam, something between 3:30 and 5:30 time, depends upon the place where you are dwelling. If you are able to get up in that particular time without any difficulty, you should feel naturally get up. And I should say you should jump out of the bed. If that condition is you are in, that means your digestion is proper, your everything is proper. These are the 15 factors by which we define or we can observe a health in a person.
It is all very well to preach about what a person must do and must not do in order to keep good health at all times. Easier said than done. Especially if the environment around you always promotes ill health in yourself and in those around you in the guise of convenience and practicability.
According to yoga, it is balance. Samatva. Samatva or balance at the physical level, at the mental level, prana level, emotional level, and at the intellectual level.
Samadosha samagnishya samadhatu malakriya prasanna atmendriya mana svasthamitya vidhiyate. Ye Sushrut Samhita ka kiya hua suprasiddha vachan hai. Isme na keval sharirik ghatkon ka hi vichar बल्कि इसमें इंद्रिय मन आत्मा इन सब का एक साथ में विशिष्ट अवस्था में संयोग होना संतुलित अवस्था में संयोग होना यह अभिप्रेत है.
A person whose doshas are in balance, perfectly balanced or in equilibrium, whose body tissues are functioning optimally, whose waste products are generated in optimum amount and evacuated at proper times, whose digestive fire or agni as we call it is functioning optimally, causing digestion to take place properly, and along with a state of well-being, mental as well as spiritual as well as your sensory motor.
आजकल जो physical measurements कहते हैं उतनी ही मर्यादित स्वास्थ्य की व्याख्या आयुर्वेद ने नहीं की. तो इसमें मानसिक संतुलन, इंद्रियों का विचार और आत्मा शायद इन तीन विषयों के कारण आयुर्वेद को एक अलग परिमाण और स्वरूप प्राप्त हुआ है. उसकी व्याप्ति और बढ़ गई है. इसीलिए आयुर्वेद इस नाम से केवल उपचारों तक की सीमित मर्यादा नहीं है. उसमें काया वाचा और मन तीनों से होने वाली सभी क्रियाओं के ऊपर निश्चित रूप से कौन सी अच्छी है कौन सी खराब है इन सब का विचार बड़े अच्छे तरीके से अपने सिद्धांतों के अनुसार ऐसे व्यक्त किया है।
എല്ലാ ദോഷങ്ങളും സമമായിട്ടിരിക്കുക, ബാലൻസ് ചെയ്തുകൊണ്ടിരിക്കുക, ധാതുക്കളൊക്കെ നേരെ ഇരിക്കുക, മലങ്ങളൊക്കെ ശരിയായിട്ട് പ്രവർത്തിക്കുക, പുറത്തേക്ക് പോകാനുള്ളത് പുറത്തേക്ക് പോയി അങ്ങനെ ശരിയായിട്ടിരിക്കുക, മനസ്സും ശുദ്ധമായിട്ടിരിക്കുക, എന്നാൽ സ്വസ്ഥനായി എന്നാണ് പറയുക.
ലൈക്ക് ഫോർ എക്സാമ്പിൾ ദേർ ഈസ് എ കണ്ടിന്യൂസ് ടിന്നിറ്റസ് ഓർ റിംഗിംഗ് ഇൻ യുവർ ഇയർ, യു വിൽ നോട്ട് ബി ഹെൽത്തി. ഔട്ട്വർഡ്ലി ദേ മേ ബി നോ സൈൻ, ബട്ട് ഇഫ് 24 അവേഴ്സ് എ ഡേ, 7 ഡേയ്സ് എ വീക്ക്, ഇഫ് ദേർ ഈസ് കണ്ടിന്യൂസ്ലി റിംഗിംഗ് ഇൻ യുവർ ഇയർ, യു കാൻ്റ് കോൾ യുവർസെൽഫ് ഹെൽത്തി.
ഹി ഷുഡ് ബി ഹാപ്പി mentally, his senses should be functioning properly, and spiritually he should be elevated. If he is not, he is not healthy according to Ayurveda.
Ek charak samhita ka sutra hai, atyant mahatvapurna hai. Vedananam adhishthano mano dehasya sendriya. Vedananam jo hota hai, gyan. Ab main swasth hu, ye bhi gyan hai. और मैं अस्वस्थ हूं, रोगी हूं, ये भी ज्ञान है. तो ये ज्ञान जो होता है वो कहां होता है? तो शरीर में और मानसिक स्तर पे हमेशा स्वस्थ या रोगी होने का एहसास होना, ज्ञान होना, ये प्रक्रिया होती है. और स्ट्रेस का मतलब जो तनाव है, चिंता है, या और कोई भीति है, भय प्रतीति बोलते हैं, ये सभी मानस भाव भी हैं, वो भी शरीर के दूसरे कारणों के जैसे ही अपने शरीर पर स्वास्थ्य या रोग रूप प्रभाव छोड़ते हैं.
When we go further, then I would say that the mind also should be healthy. And my definition of healthy mind is that how much you can tolerate people, how much you can live with them, how much you can be in a community living. So how many friends you have, you can ask somebody, and that will decide your mental health. And the spiritual health also, I would say that we can meter it out, that in given resources or in given space, time, conditions, how much you can be contented by yourself. Means if you remain somewhere in the forest and you don't feel absence of something, that if I was in city I would have done this, if there were people, but you feel that yeah, this is very beautiful and I am happy. If you are in a crowd, then you should not feel that oh, this is too much, I should go back to the forest or somewhere, but you feel that yeah, I am happy, because the happiness should come from inside.
Dhidhairi atmadi vijnanam manodoshavasam paramma. മനസ്സിനെ എല്ലാം നമ്മൾ തന്നെയാണ് കൺട്രോൾ ചെയ്യേണ്ടത്. മനസ്സിൽ നമുക്ക് കൺട്രോൾ ചെയ്യാൻ സാധിക്കുകയെന്ന് വെച്ചാൽ മറ്റേ നമ്മളിൽ അധികരിച്ചിട്ട് വേറൊന്നുമില്ല എന്നാണ്. നാം തന്നെ നമുക്ക് തന്നെ കൺട്രോൾ ചെയ്യാൻ സാധിക്കുന്നതാണ്. അപ്പം അത് നമുക്ക് കൺട്രോൾ ചെയ്യാറാവണം എന്നുണ്ടെന്ന് വെച്ചാൽ നമ്മൾ അതിനെ ആദ്യം തന്നെ അത് ക്രിയേറ്റ് ചെയ്ത് കൊണ്ടുവരാന്ന് വെച്ചാൽ നമുക്ക് സാധിക്കുന്നതാണ്. മനസ്സിന് ക്ഷീണമുള്ള കൂട്ടർക്കാണ് മാനവവ്യാധികൾ വരുന്നതാണ്. അപ്പം ഈ മനസ്സാണ് ആദ്യമായിട്ടുള്ളത്. മനസ്സും ദേഹവും രണ്ടും ഒന്നായിട്ട് തന്നെയാണ് അവൾ ബാക്കിയുള്ളവർ കണ്ടിട്ടുള്ളത്, ആയുർവേദ ശാസ്ത്രജ്ഞർ കണ്ടിട്ടുണ്ട്.
ബ്രഹ്മാസ്ത്രയുഷോദം പ്രജാപതിമധീകൃത ബ്രഹ്മാസ്ത്രയുഷോ ശ്വിനോ കൗസജസ്രാക്ഷം സോവർത്രിപുത്രാദികാമുനി തേയഗ്നിവേശാദികാം തേതു പൃഥക്ചന്ദ്രാണി തേ നിരേ തേയഗ്നിവേശ
jagati na jigad brahma pratva ayusho vedam prajapati na jigrahe.